Maybe even before phone numbers, forms are probably the most popular ways to create a contact between you and your potential client and those interested in your offerings on your website. Not all forms are built the same. Some need just a little bit more advanced technology like conditional logic. Aloha everybody, I'm Chris Joles, and today I'm showing you how to make advanced forms using conditional logic. Conditional logic allows you to create forms that seem short at the beginning, but as your potential client or user adds some information in the fields, the contact form could get longer. For instance, if you want them to leave a message, maybe that message field doesn't show up until they enter their email. Stuff like that. That way your form gets filled out correctly and nothing gets missed. Also, your forms get a little bit shorter and take up less space on your page, okay? In this video, I will be using the paid version of Ninja Forms. The paid version allows you to do great things like conditional logic, which I'm going to show you here, multi-part forms, and it comes with the great styling features. So you need to have the premium version of Ninja Forms in order to create these kinds of forms. I have a link below to the affiliate link. It helps support the channel if you use it, and let's get started. Okay, so here we are at our demo website, yourdivywebsite.com, and I've created a contact us page. You'll see on here I have a basic form, which I'll post a video above to this video if you need to know how just to create a fast, simple form with Ninja Forms. Then if we scroll down, you'll see I have an advanced form with Ninja Forms with a paid version. And this form contains some conditional logic, such as if a user clicks a button like this, it will have a new form field. You could do all kinds of things with conditional logic. You can make it so that this button doesn't show up until all these form fields are met to your requirements. So conditional logic is a great way to add more functionality to your forms. If you scroll down, I also have a video on a multi-part form that you could create with the paid version as well. So today I'm going to show you how to use this one. Real quick, if you haven't done so already, in order to use these additional functions, you do need to buy the paid version of Ninja Forms. And if you come over here to ninjaforms.com/add-ons, you can see some of the add-ons that come with the paid version, okay? And then you could always buy and get more add-ons for an extra price as well. A lot of ones you probably will not need, but it's great to know that you have such a great functionality with this plugin. Let's jump over here to the pricing just so that you could see what it costs you. So it costs $50 to get started for a year, and then after that it will be $100. Now at the time of this video, when you're watching it, I can't say that this will be the same price, but I think that's pretty affordable to get started at $50 and or $100 a year for your clients to be able to contact you and to add different features to your form. That's a great price. Okay, and obviously if you're looking to create websites for others, you might want to look at the professional one so you could create more websites. All right, I'll have a link below to Ninja Forms. If you use that link, I receive a small kickback and that helps support the channel so I can make awesome videos like this for you. And here we are at our plugins. So I've paid for the paid version of Ninja Forms. This is the regular plugin that you get for free, but you have to also go to their page and download the additional functionalities that you want. So you can't get one big plugin that has all the bonus features in there. That's kind of a good thing because it helps slim down your plugin. Only downloading what you're gonna need is a good option. So you'll see that I have downloaded the conditional logic plugin and it's activated. So we're gonna go to our Ninja Forms tab over here and we're at our Ninja Forms dashboard. And you'll see that I have already created that form that I just showed you right here. So let's just use this. We already know how to create a contact me form. So we're just gonna go ahead and open this up and I'm gonna show you how this works. Okay. So we have our form fields in here, all the form fields that we want on the page, such as we want the name, last name, and email. We want to know if they would prefer a call from us, and we want their phone number if they do, and then we want a message, okay? So, but what we want to happen on the page that the user is on, we only want their phone number if they click this. Okay, not everybody wants to give their phone number out right away, and that's fine. So you're just gonna ask them. We've created our form with all the fields that we want. So let's get started with the conditional logic. And in order to do that, you go come over here to your advanced tab, and you come over here to conditional logic. Now you may or may not see these other options here depending on the plugins you have installed, okay? So for now, you've installed a conditional logic plugin, and so we're gonna click the conditional logic option here. And you'll see here that I have the conditional logic already set up, and it's saying when would you prefer a call from us is checked, then do phone show field. Okay, form field, show field. And if not, then phone is hidden. Okay, so that's a real quick explanation of that. Let's go ahead and show you how to get this all started. So what we are going to do is go ahead and delete all these actions here, all right? So we are no longer have a form set up with conditional logic. So it's turned off, there would be no options. Let me just go ahead and show you that real quick, what that would look like with it turned off. So we're gonna publish this form. We could go ahead and come over here and open a preview. And you'll see that all our fields are being shown, okay? Would you prefer a call from us is shown, and the phone number field is shown. So what we want is this to be hidden and only to show when this clicks. All right, so let's go to our conditional logic. And so we're gonna add a new condition, okay? So the first thing we want to do is go ahead and hide our phone field. Okay, so when the would you prefer a call from us is not checked, then we want to do this. We want to take our phone field and hide it. And then if the condition is not met, such as it is checked, then we want to take our phone field and then show it. Okay, let's press done here. We're gonna publish our form, and then we're gonna go check out the preview. And then you'll see here it has, would you prefer a call from us? And then the phone number field is not here. So we're gonna select this, and it will show it. When you're doing your conditional logic, you could do it in a different order. If you would prefer to say, for instance, let's just delete this one. You could also say, when would you prefer a call from us is checked, do, we're gonna take the phone field and show, okay? And then if the condition is not met, we're gonna take the phone field and hide it. Okay, then we could press done. You don't have to press publish. You can just go over to your preview page here and refresh it. And you'll see we get the same results. The phone field is hidden. Oh, we didn't select this. So would you prefer a call from us is checked, okay? If we refresh again, we will see that the phone field is hidden, and when we select this, it is shown again, okay? So the order in which you do this isn't necessarily important as long as it makes sense, okay? This is conditional logic, so it does need to make sense. And I just showed you that, you know, a simple mistake is not checking one of these correctly can make it not work. Okay, so make sure you go through, rewatch this video if you need to, and make sure your fields are set up this way. Okay, so we're gonna press done. We are gonna press publish. Then we are gonna go back and go ahead and close this form. We're gonna take our conditional logic form, and we're gonna take our short code and copy it. And then what we're going to do is go ahead and go to our website. We are in our contact us page, and I'm just gonna go ahead and put this right at top on the top so that you could see it. We already have our examples down below, so I'm gonna delete this when I'm done. So just to remind you, there's two different ways you could put a form into your page. You can paste in the short code and it will show up on the front end. You can also, let's just open a new block here. You can also go into the Gutenberg editor and find it here as well. So we could do Ninja Form right here. We go down, select our form. And then when you do it this way, it actually shows up on your editing page. Whereas if you put the short code in, it just shows up this way. But you'll see if we go and preview the page, you'll see that the form is in there twice. We entered it once with the short code, and then we entered it again with the visual builder. So we're back here in our conditional logic, and we started a new condition. And I wanted to show you that you can select any field that you have made. You can have different equations, okay? And then you could have it do different things, such as select different fields, show and hide and require different fields. And really, you could have conditional logic within conditional logic within conditional logic and do all kinds of great things. This is just an introduction in using conditional logic with Ninja Forms. And there you go. Now you know how to make forms with conditional logic using the premium version of Ninja Forms. Again, I'll have some videos above linked to more advanced features using the Ninja Forms builder. And I'll also have my link below to the affiliate link if you need to get yourself the premium version. And you use that link, I'll get a small kickback, and I appreciate the support. Until the next video, aloha.